My name is Jira, and I'm going to do a strength routine with you today. It's all body weight, so you don't need any special equipment. I would just have a mat or a towel or maybe go on your carpet because we will be laying down for a few things. Other than that, you've got all the tools you need already. So I'll do modifications. You can work at your own pace. And we're going to have a lot of fun. We're going to sweat a little bit, and we're going to get nice and strong. I'm going to hit my music. We'll warm up. All right, just follow along. March back. March it. All right, knee up. Pull it up. Take it to a little squat. You're gonna hold it down for three. One, two, three. Stand and squeeze. One, two, three. All right, we're gonna hold it down there for seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Stand and squeeze. One, two, three. Good, kick it up. Actually, knees up. Let's do our knees first. Now kick it up. Kick it to the side. Kick it to the back. And it's like you're shutting a door. Side again. All right, kick front for four. Side for four. Back for four. Side. Cutting it down to two. Front. Side. Back. We're going to do those twos again. Front. Side. Back. Side. March it up. Big deep breath. Out. Jumping jack. If you want another option, you can be here for a low jack. Couple more. All right. I think we're ready to go. Our first exercise is going to be standing up, and we're going to be on one leg. So, if you'd like some balance assistance, go to a wall. I'm not going to go to a wall because I think I'll be out of camera range. Or grab a chair or tap your toe down. We're going to be doing a one-legged squat. So hands on hips, hold them together. outward bound to wherever it's comfortable. And we're gonna pick up one leg, squat it down. Two counts down, two counts up, nice and slow. Two, three, four. We're gonna be here a little while. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Come on, two more. 11 and 12. Good, switch legs. So our legs are, we got some big muscles there. We're gonna fire them up right away. Gets that heart rate up, gets that calorie burn going, and we get a nice long set out of the way at the beginning while you're fresh. Other leg, down, two, up, two, down, two, up, three, whoa, four. And if you lose your balance a little bit, just tap your foot. Five, happens to me all the time. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, and 12. God. Okay, legs out. We've got a plie squat. So your toes are turned out and you're coming down. We're just going to pulse it here. Pulse. Lift the right heel. Left heel. Alternate. Good, nice and low. Keep it going. Both heels up, stay down. Good, nice and low. Belly button in, lifted. Back is flat. Good, bring it up, give it a little shake. Now I like to do everything two times. You always get a second chance. So we're going back into that single leg squat. Here we go, down for two. Up. Two. Three. Four. Five. Good. Work on that balance. Six. Core is tight. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10. 11. Legs should be burning. 12. Good. All right, switching legs. Here we go. One. Two. Good. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight, nine, and 10, 11, 12. Good, shake it out a little. Toes turn out, plie squat. One, two, good, nice and low. Hold it down. Lift that right heel. Chest stays lifted. Abs are in. Switch legs. Alternate down and up. Changing on the up. Three. Four more sets. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Now both heels up, pulse it down. Chest stays lifted. Good. Rest, shake out those legs. You can give them a little stretch if you need to in between here. Grab some water if you need it. All right. We are taking it down for a whole bunch of push-ups. All different kinds. So this is where you're gonna want your mat, your towel, or if you're on carpet, you're fine. So if you have wrist issues, you have some options. You can turn these push-ups into planks where you just hold in a plank position, even with your knees down is fine. Or you can go to a wall. So I might be able to stand frame over here, but I just kind of make a diagonal with my body and I can do those push-ups against the wall. And that'll help me kind of stay upright. And it'll be a little gentler on my wrists. So either way is up to you. Try whatever your hardest level is though. So start at whatever your maximum is and you can always back off from there. So the first one we're gonna do is a pike push-up. You have your buns in the air. So you're in like a down dog or a dolphin position on your hands. And what we're gonna do is those elbows are gonna bend back and your nose is going towards the floor. So we're gonna start with a few of those and I'm gonna mix in a whole bunch of different ones. If I get to one and it doesn't work for you and you're like, oh, that doesn't feel good on my body, go back to one of the other ones I did. It's fine to repeat. No problem. All right, so we're gonna start with that pike position. Elbows are headed towards your knees. Nose is headed towards the ground. One. And two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. And eight. Kind of drop it down. All right. We're going to go to a traditional push-up. So you're widening those hands a little bit. On your feet or on your knees, you've got eight here. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Good. This one you might want to drop your knees for. It's an under the fence. So pretend like there's a little fence here in front of you. You're going to slide down. You're not really going to rest your belly on the mat. You're going to try to just kind of hover. And then we end up in like a cobra position. So you can kind of start back here in child's pose. Another way to think of it is like you're rolling a marble with your nose along the mat or a ball or something like that. So I just kind of scoot forward. I'm kind of hovering. So my belly doesn't ever actually touch the floor. And then I pull it back. So let's try together. Kind of slide that ball or that marble forward. Your arms are bent. And then at the end, you take it to that cobra position. Let's try three more of those. Roll it forward. Don't let that belly touch. Good. Two more. Roll, 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 roll. Good. I know these are kind of intense. And one more. this set, and it's a rotation. So we're gonna do a push-up, and you can be on your knees or on your feet, and then we're gonna open to a side plank. And then we'll do the other side, or if you're on your feet, you have a push-up, and then you open to that side plank. So either option is fine. We're gonna do eight of them, just like we did eight of almost everything else. So I'm gonna start on my feet. I might not make it the whole way on my feet, but I'm gonna start there. All right, here we go. One. And open. Two. Open. Three. Open. Four. Open. Five. Open. Six. Open. Seven. Open. Eight. Open. Rest. All right, give those arms a little shake, a little stretch, and we're back to the top of that exercise. So we're gonna go back to that pike plank or pike push-up, and then under the regular push-up, we're gonna roll that ball under the fence and rotational push-up. So we're gonna go through that one more time. Make any changes that you need to. All right, join me in that pike. Down and up for eight. Your hands are a little closer together than they would be for a normal traditional push-up. Down and up. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And we come down. Widen those hands. Now you're on your feet or your knees. We've got that traditional push up in there. Just eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Rest. Okay, we're taking it back to child's pose-ish. And then we're going to roll that ball under the fence, end up in that cobra. Try not to let that belly scrape on the mat. You want it just to kind of hover a little bit. Starting back here, we've got four of these. Roll that ball, bring it up and through. Go, push it back. And roll that ball up and through. And push it back. Two more. Roll. Go, push it back. And you've got one more. Roll and push it back. All right. Our last one is that rotational push-up. So we're going to open to that side plank. Here we go. Down and up. One. Open. Two. Open. Three. Open. Four. Open. Five. Open. Six. Open. Seven. Open. And eight. Open. Rest. Shake everything out. Grab some water. And we're going to move on. Now this next one, we are coming down to the floor. I like to do it off my mat because I feel like if I'm on my mat, I'm going to slide. But I'm going to give you some options so you can kind of make that choice and see what works better for you. It's called a walking plank. So we're going to go down with one leg. And it doesn't matter if you're opposite with me. I know the video flips when you're watching it. So you can absolutely be on your left leg when I'm on my right leg, it doesn't matter. What you're gonna do is you're gonna step back. I'm stepping back with my right leg, right, left, and I end up in that plank position. And then I come up the same way I went down, like someone hit the rewind. Left, right, and then back up. Right, left, right. And of course we'll do both sides. So if you're on the opposite leg as me, it doesn't matter, because we'll do both sides. If you want something a little bit less intense, you're gonna stay down in your plank, and you can be on your knees or your toes, and you're gonna tap the shoulders. You can even be on forearms, on your knees or on your toes, and tap. That's gonna take some of that weight off your wrist. If your wrists are feeling it after those push-ups or anything like that, you can always take that option too. All right, so we're standing tall if you're coming with me. I like to be off your mat. If you do want to go on your mat, I would just say make sure you're 100% on your mat. So don't have your feet off on the back, because then that mat might slide away from you. All right, we're gonna do 10 on each side. Here we go. Right, left, right. And we're gonna go a little quick. That heart rate's gonna start coming up. Right, left, right. That's two. Three. If you need a different pace than me, that's okay too. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Nine. And 10. All right, shake those legs out. We're gonna pause here quick. I have part two coming your way. If you are spent, you're gonna lay down and stretch. If you're gonna join me for part two, grab a drink of water, and we'll be back for part two in a second.